happiness just outside my window. I thought it crashed, blowing 80 miles an hour. The happiness, a little more like knocking on your door. You just let it.
Michael Shearer, her son,
and
gives my daughter,
and his daughter, Heather Shearer.
He gives her mom away to our father.
Are you taking a picture with my camera?
Dad, be quiet.
Underneath the hoopah.
With my camera.
Wait.
We before God, with our friends and family, renew our vows after 30 years of marriage. They live together through rough and tough times, through the good and fun times. The both of them with their children and their life to share for each orphan as a family. To go through life as a couple, as the best, not only as a couple, but as the best of friends. They are loved by everyone who meets them and are lucky enough to be with them. When their love and energy and their loving and caring is shared through their friends and family. Doug and Ellen.
Okay, so now, dear friends, out of affection for Ellen and Doug,
the rabbi,
we have gathered together to witness and bless their mutual vows, which will unite them in marriage. To this moment, they bring the fullness of their hearts as a treasure to share with one another. They bring that particular personality and spirit, which is uniquely their own, and out of which will grow the reality of their life together. We rejoice with them, an outward sign of an inward union of hearts, a union created by friendship, respect, and love. Just read that part.
Each of you giving something to yourself into their lives. Your love, guidance, and encouragement will mostly definitely be appreciated. It is fitting to them that they should share today in the celebration of Doug and Ellen's commitment to God and to each other to live their lives as one. We gather that you are here. Doug and Ellen wish that you accept their heartfelt invitation to be as important a part of their tomorrow as it is for their today.
Ellen and Doug, have you come together today so that you may seal and strengthen your love in the presence of God, family, and friends?
Yes, we do.
Doug and Ellen have written their vows themselves, therefore making them that much more sacred. Before this gathering, they have chosen to share their vows. Doug, please begin.
Ellen, we stand here together on this, our wedding day, a day that I feel is the most important day of our lives. You came into my life on a whim, and through our many separate ways, came together to unite a relationship that has taken us to a point in time in which we stand before God to say our vows in holy matrimony. This is not the end, but a new beginning. Our lives have led us here, and it will lead us on our darkness. We'll find the sunshine. Our coldness, we'll find warmth. Through our sorrows, we will find friendships. Through the many conflicts, we will find peace. Let's follow our footsteps, which will lead us on and open our eyes to the future. Reach for our rainbow. Search for a smile. It captured the sun in our hearts. This is not an end, but yet a new beginning. As we will together towards our future, the road leads us on. I promise to love you and cherish you for the rest of my life. You have given me strength and rest our pride and dignity and help me find belief in myself that I've never been able to hold on till now. Let us open our hearts and discover our new beginning. Amen.
Amen.
L'chaim.
Doug, today I give you my hand so that you will hold on to me always. I do not know what the future holds, but I do believe our love can help us meet the challenges in life and to grow as persons. I believe marriage is establishing a relationship which the independence is equal, the dependence is mutual, and the obligation is reciprocal. I, Ellen, choose you, Doug, to be my husband, my friend, my love, and the father of our children. I promise to appreciate and participate in your spontaneity, to encourage and support your interests. I covenant to love you in the everydayness of life, in sickness and in health, to comfort you in times of sorrow, to participate with you in times of joy, to share with you the responsibility of building a loving home, to allow you to differ with me, to give you the freedom to be creative. I will honor your goals and help you fulfill them. On this day, I affirm the relationship we have enjoyed, looking to the future to deepen and strengthen it. I will be yours in plenty and in want, in failure and in triumph. I will be open to you, and I pledge to stay with you as long as we shall live freed and bound by our love. I give you myself, of which, thanks to you, I now am. I give you all of my trust, all of my tomorrows, and ask that you accept me as your wife.
We have heard Doug and Ellen pledge themselves to God and each other in marriage. The wedding ring is the outward and visible sign of an inward and spiritual grace, signifying to all the unity of this man and woman in holy matrimony. Okay, Doug, are you ready? In token and pledge, say it, Doug.
Say it.
In token and pledge.
We don't.
In token and pledge.
In token and pledge.
Of our constant faith and abiding love.
In constant our faith and abiding love.
With this ring.
With this ring.
I be wed. Okay, Ellen, you.
Okay.
I don't know if we can do this.
I couldn't get it.
All right, we'll play it until we get it off.
It's okay. Okay.
In token and pledge.
In token and pledge.
Of our constant faith and abiding love.
Of our constant faith and abiding love.
With this ring.
With this ring.
I be wed.
I be wed.
Each of them have wrote new vows to each other.
Okay.
Which I feel that they should both read now.
Now.
Doug.
Jody, you have the other one?
Sunset in West Hampton. 9/6/13. 30 years ago, we stood before each other and declared our commitment to each other before our family and friends. It was the beginning. Now, 30 years and 4 months later, we stand before each other to renew and commemorate our commitment again. A bit older, but more wiser, and all the more richer of experiences and events that transcends time. Many joyful, some are very painful, with our amazing children and good friends. You have and always will be the center of my universe, my tower of support, my guardian of illness, and the keeper of my sanity. Your unwavering loyalty to me and our family only reinforces what I knew those 30-some-odd years ago. You and I were meant to be together, and I hereby renew my commitment to be a better wife, partner, and friend as we venture to the next part of our journey. I am sure those in heaven are watching over us and smiling down. I love you always and forever,
Francesca.
So now, Doug and Ellen, I do pronounce you man and wife after 30 years again.
Oh,
the home to be.
Everybody wave to the camera, please. Come on, everybody.
There you go.